Have a few extra cards lying around? Looking to turn your rotating staples into a Theros booster box? Check out Channel Fireball's online buy list. We offer the most competitive prices on all of your unwanted cards, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a hefty 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's fast, it's easy, and as LSV would say, it's good value.
Rise of the Eldrazi is back online, so obviously that means I've got to do some drafts. And this pack is also very stacked. We've got Bear Umbra, which is kind of like a Sword and Feast and Famine. We've got Lust for War, which, as we all know, is one of the underrated gems throughout almost the entire time that Rise was a draftable. Card that won me, I think, more matches than any other card, especially in the drafts I recorded. Kabir Vindicator, which is good. Pollant Ulamog, which is decent. And, Dread Drone, which is fine. But basically, it becomes between Lust for War and Bear Umbra, since I think Vindicator's alright and Pawn's alright, but nothing to really compare to these two. I feel like Bear Umbra might be better. Let's see, you slam this on a creature. It's a +2/+2 in Totem Armor, which is already pretty good, and it's basically free. Whereas Lust for War is also insane. I've got to take Bear Umbra, though. I think it's barely better, but it is better. And, alright, follow up with Overgrown Battlement, which actually seems like a pretty good pick. If I had taken Lust for War, I'd probably take Emrakul's Hatcher, since I always felt like Hatcher and Battlement were close enough together that I would take the card that I already had in the same color. This person took a rare Passing Last Kiss. Narcolepsy is also good. Essence Feed's decent. Worse than Dread Drone, though. Inquisition of Kozlik probably worth something. Guard Gomazo, which is fine. But Overgrown Battlement was one of the better green commons, and green, I think, is the best color, so I'm not unhappy just taking that. And getting a third pick Magma? What is going on? I mean, this card's very good. Near-Death Experience is sweet, too, though not obviously very good. It's also a Last Kiss, Bloodrite Invoker, Wave Watch, which was pretty underrated, Escape Null, which was fine, Heart Beast, which is good. I heart the beast with a Bear Umbra here, but I'm going to take Magma. Magma is just a sick card, and the red-green tokens deck's pretty good, and Bear Umbra is good when you have random, decently sized creatures. Alright, this pick's a lot more disappointing. There's actually no playable card in this pack. Wow. I mean, Merfolk Sky Scout is fine, but I'm not taking it after, you know, this start, especially since I didn't love drafting blue, surprisingly enough. Boulderfoot, Lagok Lizard, Haze Frog, these are all just mediocre cards. I think I'm just going to take Evolving Wilds. I end up splashing often enough that just taking that seems fine. Let's see if this improves. That's a late Kabir Vindicator. There's also a Prophetic Prism, so could go in any direction. There's Balaged Scorpion, which is fine. Siege Runner, Haze Frog, Might of the Masses. None of these are really great. I kind of just want to take the Prophetic Prism and just see where that takes us here. And takes us into the land of more unplayables. I guess I just take, I don't even know, there's no cards here. I guess I just take Goblin Arsonist because it combines well with Magma. And it's good in the Sacrifice deck. I mean, I don't even like Core Lineslinger, and I don't really like white, so alright, I'll take the Arsonist. This is fading quickly, though. Mnemonic Wall is a sweet card. Might of the Masses is okay if you end up in that deck. I'm not saying that it's a guarantee that I do. There's Zofshade, which isn't great. Arrogant Bloodlord, which I don't really like. Caravan Escort, which is okay, but I feel like I'm pretty deep into not, at this point, to taking a random white leveler is not what I want to do. I might just take this. Alright, let's see how that goes. Alright, well, there's another Prophetic Prism, but I don't think I need that. There's also a Pennon Blade, which is, again, good if you get tokens. I don't really have any token enablers yet, though I've got a lot of things that take use of them. There's also an Escaped Null, which I have found to be a fine card. It's a good defender. Alright, I guess I could take the Blade and from here on out be ready, or I could just take Prism. I'm just going to take the Prism and just take the sweetest card out of every pack. Though in this case, that's probably a Stomper Cub, because it's such a good combo with Bear Umbra, as lame as that is, since I really don't like Hand of Emrakul. It is not worth the effort. Same with Demonic Appetite. Well, I'll take some Shared Discoveries or something, but I'm not really going to worry about messing with the bad enablers here. Ooh, I could take Vent Sentinel. I don't have any other defenders except Overgrown Battlement, but that is a decent deck. I don't like Warmonger's Chariot much. Alright, yeah, that seems like a reasonable thing to take. Battle Rattle Shaman is also a good enabler here, and even though I have all these Prisms and stuff, I don't need to take Seagate Oracle. Though, might actually be the best here, since I do like the Shaman, but yeah, Seagate Oracle's sweet. These are mostly nonsense. I will hide this Inatu Golem right away. Since I figure if I'm going to try to splash Shared Discovery, the Ancestral Recall of the format, I might as well take Seagate Oracle, which enables that quite well. Take and hide Haze Frog. Same with Jawari Scuttler. Alright, so hoping for a slightly better pack two, though. I mean, my first three picks were really good. Like, Bear Umbra, Overgrown Battlement, and then into Magma, but felt like I guess I was getting cut after that, or maybe the packs were weak. The packs mostly had bad cards. There were some decent white cards and a decently light blue card, so maybe I just should have been in one of those colors. All right, what do we got here? We've got Growth Spasm, which is a good ramp card. We've got Bore Umbra, which is a good mid-range card. Though, if we pick up some Aura Gnarlids, Bore Umbra is pretty sick. There's Hedron Field Purists, which is a cool card, but definitely not what I'm taking here. So it really is the two green cards that I think are competing at this point. I could take Dongler Invoker. I've got three ways to splash it, and the Invoker is very powerful. But I'm kind of leaning towards just taking Growth Spasm. Once I have that, then I can truly just ignore colors when I take cards. Alright, yeah, I'm just going to take the Growth Spasm. That seems sweet. And, alright, it's going to be hard to argue with Flame Slash. It's so much more efficient than Heat Ray. I like Surakar Spellblade, but this is not the deck for it. I like Rapacious One, but I think Flame Slash is a lot better. It's just a random big dude where you can find clones for that. I like Dread Drone, but removal is few and far between. Alright, I'm just going to keep taking removal cards, and eventually I'll figure out something to do with all of them. Since Flame Slash is still better than Bloodrite Invoker here, I think. It's funny that I have all this fixing, but yet to really take a card that matters. Or that really isn't in these colors. And I think I have to take Undo Giant at this point, since Explosive Revelation is fine. Explosive, it's basically a Erratic Explosion, but you get to keep the card. But Undo Giant is just so good. Alright. Undo Giant it is, and then I swear we're done with fixing. Until a second Undo Giant comes along. Yeah, I mean, I kind of want to take that too, since I don't think Rapacious One is that great. All right, now we've got enough fixing, right? All right, so now I take Bloodrite Invoker. Easy. Yeah, there's a Shared Discovery, but Bloodrite Invoker is very good. I don't have enough enablers for Shared Discovery yet, and you can pick up Shared Discovery late, generally. These are all nonsense. I could take Penblade, but again, don't have enough that would really make me want to play it, whereas Rapid Flames is a decent sideboard card and an okay main deck card if you have to. Right, ooh, Colony Hydra, interesting. So, green less to cast for each green creature you control, and it costs 8. So it's going to cost 7 green or 6 green if I have 2 of these things. That, I don't know if that's better than Vent Sentinel, and I don't know if Vent Sentinel is better than Essence Feed. Let's see, we've got no real uses for tokens at this point. But we also only have one wall plus the other Vent Sentinel. I'm going to take Vent Sentinel. I feel like this could be a good wall deck. All right, Spore Cap Spider also works. Ooh, there's a Mnemonic Wall. I've got 2 Flame Slashes, Growth Spasm. Yeah, that's about it. I mean, Might of the Mass isn't really a thing. But Mnemonic Wall, first of all, works with the wall theme. Second of all, getting Flame Slashes back actually is very good. So if I can pick up one more removal spell, like a Heat Ray or a Last Kiss or something, then this Mnemonic Wall could really actually end up paying off. I already have a Rapid Flame, so now I'm going to take Leaf Arrow as a good sideboard card. Alright, and now I guess a Reinforced Bulwark. Since I don't think I want to splash Guard Duty, I mean, I guess I could splash it kind of free, but Reinforced Bulwark, if I do end up with 3 or 4 Vent Sentinels, actually is a good card. I'll take Gravity Well. Well then. Alright, Hides Nonsense, and something else, sorry, Gravity Well. So, probably not playing this Goblin Arsonist or Might of the Masses. That doesn't look like the direction we're going to really go, but this looks alright. This Bear Umbra is not actually being at its best here, but that's okay.